Good day, folks. My name's Raymond Moore, and I'm here with the RV Corral in beautiful, sunny Eugene, Oregon. I want to start off by saying thanks for watching this video. I'm not going to keep it too long. I do want to hit some high points of this 2014 hideout. It's the 23RKS, which is basically the rear kitchen slide-out model. The hideouts are built over in Eastern Oregon, over in Pendleton. So we're local, we don't have to pay $2,500 freight to get them out of Indiana, so it means it's an exceptionally good buy. If you're looking for a late model trailer, you might want to move yourself up into a brand new hideout. Features like Diamond Shield on the front, the newer propane tanks that open from the top to access the valves. We do have the power awning over here on the curbside. We have the black tank flush, which is the flusher to flush out our black tank. We have the outside hookup for my TV. So my TV, I can just unhook from the inside and move to the outside if I want to watch a football game. Fresh water, 60 gallons, which is quite a bit more than most of the other products out there. Nice entrance, double step with a nice grab handle going in. On the back end, we have the ladder going up on top of the roof. Now, some folks, some trailer manufacturers won't offer the ladder to go up on top of the roof. And the reason being is they don't want you on top of the roof. It's not safe on top of the roof. Whereas hideouts, that's a full walk-on roof. Outside shower, which is nice, hot and cold water. Rinse off some nice fresh crab so you don't take the smell inside the trailer. And down here I have my 30 amp hookup service, which is just goes inside the trailer, and my city water hookup is right here. 6 gallon quick recovery hot water heater, satellite hookup, or it can be utilized for a cable hookup too. One thing I do want to show you, and that is a Keystone product, and that is if I have a twig that gets in here and I don't know it and it's going to rain tonight, water goes in, and normally where does it go? It goes right inside the travel trailer and Mama gets a little upset. Whereas here you can see we actually have a gutter. So the water comes in, hits the gutter, and where does it go? It goes to the outside of the trailer, not to the inside. So let's go inside, folks. Stay with me here. Grab a pen, piece of paper, because at the end of the video, it's going to give you some information on how to contact me. And I really would appreciate, folks, if you're looking for a trailer, to give me a call, stop by. We're going to start off in the rear kitchen model here. And we have the new Atwood. This is a helium refrigerator. It's a 7 cubic foot. The helium is a new technology. It actually will warn you if you're not completely level where you should be. And the coolest thing is, and it won't come on right now, but I have an LED light that comes down out of the top down here. And it's a blue light. It's really cool. Kids love it. Microwave up above, oven down below with a high output 3-burner stove. Nice little setup here in the kitchen. Very well done, very well finished. Got 3 drawers going down, plus a little bit of storage for a trash can down here so I don't have to have it outside. If you notice, we use metal grates. They're not plastic. Some of the other manufacturers, they'll use the plastic grates. They get brittle, they can crack. So this one here is actually set up for sleeping for 6 people. We do have the ducted roof air conditioning up above. Comes with a flat screen TV, AM, FM, stereo, CD, DVD player, playing right through my TV. Table will drop down and make into a nice sleepable bedroom area. And I will point out to you that we have, excuse me Curtis, I'll squeak by you here, jalousie windows. Now I really like the dinette on my curbside because then I've got my awning. I can sit here and look out on the curbside so I can look at my stuff, my bikes, my picnic table. And then I have jalousie windows. The jalousie windows will open outwards. Very, very easy. They'll pop out and the jalousie windows will come out this way. So I don't have to worry about it raining at nighttime, but I can still get ventilation. And everybody knows we need ventilation in travel trailers or we get condensation. This is slid out right now. Sofa makes down into a nice sleepable bed. Thoughtful. Got a shelf in the back here. So if we're sitting here wanting to read the paper or have a cup of coffee, where am I going to put my coffee cup? Well, the nice little shelf there. Closet in here, which is a nice place for like jackets, for example. So they're not in the bedroom area itself. I really like this floor plan because it's very open in the bedroom. I have my sink here. I have my garden shower off to the other side, which Curtis will come around and show you, with a skylight up above. So if you're over 6 feet tall, you can stand in there and take a shower. And on the opposite side, I have my stool in a privacy room all by itself. And that is a China stool, folks, which is kind of nice. In the bedroom, shirt closets either side, nothing new really there. I have storage up above. And then underneath my bed, I am going to have storage underneath. So if I want to put some boots, a shoe rack down here, extra clothing, extra jeans in case you need some. The other thing is, nice door. So I have access and entry from both the door in by the kitchen and the door in the bedroom, which is really kind of cool. We use linoleum vinyl floor throughout, which is really nice because it's very easy to keep clean. You know, who wants to vacuum carpets in a travel trailer? I've hit on some high points, folks. Great buy in these hideouts, year-end closeouts. If you're looking to buy something for Christmas, put underneath the Christmas tree. My name's Raymond Moore. I'm here with the RV Corral in Eugene, Oregon. Call me, email me, stop by. Let's have a cup of tea. But I want to thank you very much for watching this video. Have a wonderful holiday. Thank you.